रीडिंग फ्रॉम चैतन्य चारितमृता आदि लीला चैप्टर 2 टेक्स्ट 12। जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद। जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद। जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद। सो तानहार अंगेरा शुदा किरण मंडला उपनिषद कहे तानरे ब्रह्मा सुनिर्मला। Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. What the Upanishads call the transcendental impersonal Brahman is the realm of the glowing effulgence of the same Supreme Person. So now the explanation is given here. Where is that? What is this light, the divine light that everyone gets so baffled by? So, because it's so dazzling, it covers our vision of the Supreme Lord. The three mantras of the Mundaka Upanishad 2.2 from 9 to 11 give information regarding the bodily effulgence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They state, now Mundaka Upanishad is one of the Upanishad, and in the Upanishad, they are giving, in this Mundaka Upanishad is telling us, what is this light? What is this divine light, as we call? Okay. Hiranmaye parekoshe virajam brahma nishkalam takchur chubram jyotisham jyotis tadyat atma vidho viduhu na tatsuryo bhati na chandra tarakam nema vidyuto bhanti kuto yam agnihi तम एव भान्तम् अनुभाति सर्वं तस्य भासा सर्वं इदं विभाति ब्रह्म वेदं अमृतं पुरस्ताद् ब्रह्म पश्चात् ब्रह्म दक्षिणतश्चोत्तरेण अधश्चोर्ध्वं च पृष्ठं ब्रह्म वेदं विश्वं इदं वरिष्ठम्। In the spiritual realm, beyond the material covering, is the unlimited Brahman effulgence, which is free from material contamination. That effulgent white light is understood by transcendentalists to be the light of all lights. In that realm, there is no need of sunshine, moonshine, fire, or electricity for illumination. Indeed, whatever illumination appears in the material world is only a reflection of that supreme illumination. That Brahman is in front and in the back, in the north, south, east, and west, and also overhead and below. In other words, that supreme Brahman effulgence spreads throughout both the material and spiritual skies. So the Upanishads are telling us about this white light, the Brahman, the Brahma Jyoti, which we have been hearing from past few days, that this is the personal effulgence coming from the body of Krishna. We all have experience when we see sunshine, we know that means, oh, the sun is there. The sunshine is coming from the sun planet. Similarly, when we see any light anywhere, we will understand, oh, there is a source of light. There'll be a bulb, there'll be a tube light. Something will be there, the source of light. Similarly, the source of this divine light, which is everywhere, the spiritual world, the material worlds are all situated on these lights, on this light. Everything is situated from there. And this is the origin of all illumination in this material world. The light of the sun, the moon, is coming from this light. And what is this light? It is the light which is the effulgence. It's coming from the body of the Lord. It's coming from the body of Krishna, and it spreads everywhere. There's not one inch or even one point that is not covered by the Brahma Jyoti. It's called the Brahma Jyoti, and it's all pervading. Even the material world is situated on the Brahma Jyoti. One part of this bright light gets covered dark with Mahatattva, you know? And that's the reason this material world is so dark, because it's covered by this Mahatattva. So reading on text 13, charma chakshe dekhe yaiche surya nirvishesha jnana marge laite nare krishnera vishesha. As with the naked eye, one cannot know the sun except as a glowing substance, merely by philosophical speculation. One cannot understand Lord Krishna's transcendental varieties. When we are just looking at the sun with our eyes, we just see that, oh, it's just something glowing, you know, some effulgence is coming from this looks like something round is there, looks like there's some round and some rays are coming from it. We can't know it in detail by just looking at it. So similarly, what's pointed here is by philosophical speculation. As we just heard from Srimad Bhagavatam, no matter how much we try to understand Krishna through our mental logic or word jugglery, we won't be able to understand him. He can be understood only by bhakti, only by hearing and chanting. Bhakti begins with hearing and chanting. Then, of course, deity worship, remembering, prayers, all that. So, yasya prabha prabhavato jagat andakoti. I'm sorry, please excuse me. Koteshva ashesha vashudadi vibhuti vibhanam, binam, vibhuti binam, tad brahma nishkalam anantam ashesha bhutam govindam adi purusham tam aham bhajami. I worship Govinda, the primeval Lord, who is endowed with great power. The glowing effulgence of his transcendental form is the impersonal Brahman, which is absolute, complete, and unlimited, and which displays the varieties of countless planets with their different opulences in millions and millions of universes. So we can see how Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita is so connected. We were just hearing in Bhagavatam that how Brahmaji, after he engaged in devotional service, he spoke the Brahma Samhita. And this verse is coming from the Brahma Samhita. This is one of the verses that Brahmaji spoke, which is a part of the Brahma Samhita. Okay, so this verse appears in the Brahma Samhita 5.40. Each and every one of the countless universes is full of innumerable planets with different constitutions and atmospheres. So it's not only one universe, there are unlimited number of universes. And in each universe, there are so many planets, so many stars, we are not even able to count all of them. And then in each planet, there is a different atmosphere. It's differently constituted. All these come from the unlimited non-dual Brahman or complete whole, which exists in absolute knowledge. So where are all these situated in all these numberless, countless planets? They're all situated on the Brahman, on the Brahma Jyoti. Sorry, the light which is coming from God. The origin of that unlimited Brahman effulgence is the transcendental body of Govinda, who's offered respectful obeisances as the original and supreme personality of Godhead. So because many people get confused, what is all this about? What's the absolute truth? What's the ultimate truth? What is this material world? What is the spiritual world? So the material world, spiritual world, everything is situated on this Brahma Jyoti, as people call it, the white light or the divine light. And the source of this Brahma Jyoti is Supreme Lord Krishna, who's also called as Govinda. One of his names is Govinda, one who gives pleasure to the cows and the senses. So this Brahma Jyoti is coming out from his body. It's his personal effulgence. Any questions or comments?
All clear.
Okay. Text 15. Koti koti brahmande ye brahmera vibhuti Se Brahma Govindera Haya Angakanti. Lord Brahma said, the opulences of the impersonal Brahman spread throughout the millions and millions of universes. That Brahman is but the bodily effulgence of Govinda. So many people just get lost in this light because they cannot see anything beyond the light because it's spreading everywhere. There's not one inch that is not where this light is not there. And so people get confused. They start thinking, oh, this light is the ultimate. But this light is just the bodily effulgence of Krishna. This light, which is called the Brahman, the impersonal Brahma Jyoti, it is just the bodily effulgence of Krishna, of Govinda. Text 16, say Govinda bhajiyami teho mora pati tanhara prasade mora haya shrishti shakti. I worship Govinda. He is my Lord. Only by his grace am I empowered to create the universe. So we saw Brahmaji, he was born, but he couldn't understand what to do. He couldn't understand until and unless he got this intelligence from Krishna. So he's saying these prayers. Although the sun is situated far away from the other planets, its rays sustain and maintain them all. Indeed, the sun diffuses its heat and light all over the universe. Similarly, the Supreme Sun, Govinda, diffuses his heat and light everywhere in the form of his different potencies. So just as sun is there, from the sun, all the planets in the universe are getting the light. All the planets, doesn't matter where they are situated. So similarly, it's said that Krishna, Govinda, he's there in Golok Vrindavan. And from him, this Brahma Jyoti is coming, where it's spreading everywhere. The sun's heat and light are non-different from the sun. In the same way, the unlimited potencies of Govinda are non-different from Govinda himself. So Krishna has many, many different potencies, many different energies. And so they are non-different. Just as we say the sunshine is non-different than the sun. You know, so we can say they're simultaneously one and different. When we say, oh, the sun is in my room. It's not really the sun planet that's in the room, but the sunshine is in the room. So we use it in that context. So similarly, all these energies of Krishna, they are non-different from Krishna. Why? Because they belong to him. Everything belongs to Krishna. There's nothing that does not belong to Krishna. There's no one that does not belong to Krishna. And when we think that something does not belong to Krishna or is not a part of Krishna, that is conditioned life. That's the reason we are here in this material world, because we think that things are different from Krishna. That there are some things which do not belong to Krishna. That's conditioned life. Therefore, the all-pervasive Brahman is the all-pervasive Govinda. The Bhagavad Gita 14.27 clearly mentions that the impersonal Brahman is dependent on Govinda. That is the real conception of absolute knowledge. So Krishna is omnipresent, right? God is omnipresent. How is omnipresent? Through his energy. What is that? The Brahman. Brahman is everywhere. Everywhere. His effulgence is everywhere. So Krishna is everywhere. Because the Brahman is his light, it's his effulgence. So when we say that the Brahman is everywhere, it means Krishna is everywhere. It doesn't mean he stops being a person. It doesn't mean because his light is everywhere, he's not a person. That is the inconceivable potency. That's why he's God. God is unlimited. He's inconceivable. He can be a person, means he can be localized in one place, and yet he can be everywhere. So how is he everywhere? By this Brahman effulgence, by his Paramatma potency, he's everywhere. Yet he's there in the Golok Vrindavan, having his most sweetest pastimes. And also in the various Vaikuntha planets as Lord Narayan. Is that okay?
Yes.
Yes. So we'll stop here for today for Chaitanya Charitamrita. Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita ki jai Shrila Prabhupada ki jai Gaura Premanande Hari.